Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're going to be doing a simple makeup tutorial. So for the first step, you will have to wash your face and prep your face very well for a long lasting makeup. So for moisturizer, I'm using Nivea moisturizer. This is really keeping my skin very hydrated, especially during these winter times. So make sure before you do anything, apply a moisturizer on daily basis as well. So once you're done moisturizing your face, moisturize your lips. You can use any lip balm. I'm using Maybelline's Baby Lips lip balm today. It's very soft and it doesn't last for long, but you know, before wearing your lipstick, you can wear this lip balm. Okay, let's start with the makeup. The first step for makeup is primer. Never skip this step because it's going to act as a shield between your prepped moisturized skin and your makeup. You don't want the makeup to penetrate into your skin and give you bad reactions. So this is going to act like a shield. So please never avoid a primer. There are so many primers available out there. I'm using Colabar. I've been using Colabar for a really long time. But hereafter in our channel, we're going to try out new products and I'm going to be more consistent in my videos as well. Just took a small break. So for the next step, I'm using concealer from Maybelline. Concealer, sometimes you can apply it after applying your foundation. Or before. Whichever is more comfortable for you, but I am used to applying concealer before my foundation and I'm using my finger. In today's video, I'm not going to be using any brushes. I'm going to be either using my finger or a blending brush, nothing else. You know, let's work with minimalism. So just blend, do not, rub, dab. Do not rub it. The outcome will not be great if you rub the concealer or anything on your face. Makeup should be always dabbed. Okay guys, this is my new foundation. After like 5 years, I'm changing my foundation. I went to the drugstore and the person is like, why don't you try this foundation? It's from Chamber. It was animal cruelty free, so I'm very supportive about it. So I just thought, let me give a try. I will leave the shade in the description box below. And it's very liquidy actually. The one thing, not one thing, many things disappointed me in this foundation is that I had to, you know, build up a lot. Unlike Maybelline or Huda Beauty, this one I'll have to apply it 2 to 3 times for the effect to happen. But it can go from light to medium to heavy coverage also. It depends on how much you build up. Definitely, it's not going to give you the outcome in the first stroke. But today, I'm applying a very, very simple makeup. So, and one major drawback about this foundation for me was it started graying out. It's the first time I ever felt after applying the foundation, my face started graying out. So I was really disappointed because I bought this and I cannot waste it. So I'm just going to work with this and, you know, I'm going to mix and match with other foundations that I have. Let's see. And I will let you all know how I'm making it work so that you guys also don't have to, you know, waste the products that you've bought and you feel it doesn't suit you. If it doesn't suit you, either give it away to somebody or make it work on your skin. Never throw. And this is the favorite product that I bought this time. This is the first time in my life I'm buying a highlighter and I wanted to try it so badly because I've never tried highlighter, and as you can see I am applying it in a way like, you know, so minimal. I was so scared if I apply so much, you know, so much of product is going to come onto my face and I'm going to look like a clown. That's why I was applying very, very less, but we'll work on it too. So then I'm dabbing it with a blending blender. So after this tutorial only, I understood something, that you need to apply it under your eyes. You know, apply it really heavy. That's how it's going to pop out your, you know, under eye wherever you want the highlighting points to be. So this is one mistake I made in this tutorial, so just forgive me. But my middle of my nose looks bright. See, that's how under your eyes are supposed to look. So next time when we use it, we'll use it in the right way. So let's also learn the ways that we are not supposed to use a product. So this is one of it. Then I'm moving on to powder, setting powder. As usual, I'm going to be using the blender for the powder, blush and foundation. I don't know, I've become so comfortable with this single product which is used for multiple uses. You know, I'm just setting the powder around my, T-zones and oily zones. I don't usually apply the powder throughout my face. That is one trick to make you look young. Don't apply the powder throughout your face. That makes you look very old. Apply it only under your eyes, around your mouth and on your T-zone. There should be that shine on your face, you see, that glow. So hopefully, I think I've covered up everything. For the next step, I am taking the Blue Beauty Blender and I'm doing the blush part. Then moving on to our eyes. So the first step in my eye makeup routine is always curl the lashes, which will pop your eyes out. But be very careful and make sure the rubber is there on the eyelash. Otherwise, you will have a eyelash trim. So then next I'm going on to applying the eyeliner. This is from Maybelline as well. You know, I haven't bought new products yet because I'm somebody who doesn't want, you know, keep piling up products. But if you're into makeup, you need to try out new stuff, right? So please do watch out my channel. I will be trying out new stuff and I will be more consistent, guys. Then for mascara, again this lashes from Maybelline, which gives you really really voluminous lashes. You know, you can apply it twice as also if you want really voluminous lashes, but I prefer applying it once. That itself is much enough for me. So once I'm done with my lashes, I will move on to my lips. For this lipstick, I got this from Miniso, which I regret to this day. Why the hell did I do that? But I wanted something subtle, not too heavy. So I applied this one. Don't buy lipsticks from Miniso. Don't buy any makeup items from Miniso. You can buy some eyebrow pencil, eyeliner or glitters from Miniso, which is really worth it. But lipsticks, not much. And please don't invest in creams, face washes and all. For now, let days go by and people, there will be people who will really want to try it. Get some reviews, then try it. So that's it, guys. Hope I made the video pretty simple. And let's talk about the elephant in the room. Please let me know how my new hairstyle looks. In 7 years, this is the first time I've cut my hair for a very, very good purpose. So please let me know how it looks and please support me to do more videos, because I really need your encouragement to do videos. I've been feeling really low nowadays. That's why for the past 2 months I skipped doing videos. So hereafter I've made up my mind, change that attitude and give you guys more. So until I meet you all soon, take care. Bye.